project, and your resources cannot take on new project. Efficiency and quality. Payment, your procurement, your finance. How do you negotiate with your supplier and so on? And the effect of cash flow as well. So this is the typical business issue faced by a lot of SME. Okay? So now, when your customer is happy, they will leave. So, I want to highlight here, you know, people always think that KPI is only for sales. It's not. You can be for many areas. So quality issue, rejection of goods, cost, loss of profits, slow delivery, satisfaction affected, slow response time also, losing client, some affecting business margin, stock control, cash flow, poor quality management affect cash flow, poor sales follow up. These are the things that are affecting your company's profitability. So isn't it important, right? Employees' performance, so important. So that's why you cannot ignore all the employees' performance. You have to define the right KPI to measure the employees' KPI and monitor them. That is so important. Do not wait until the year end, it's too late. Okay? So now, let's look at this. What's wrong with the appraisal form design? Okay, I want to have an interaction here. You can give your feedback, whether you agree or not agree, then we can learn together, right? So please share, please ask questions. So what's wrong with the appraisal form design? Let me share with you. Conventional appraisal form. Right? Looks very familiar, right? So your first page, your employee name, company, confirmation, contract renewal, right? So then you have very nice table here showing outstanding, 9 to 10, and so on, right? Okay. So, okay, now, appraisal. So you have planning and organizing skill. You have setting objective result focus. So you have to keep a score for employee, right? Some of you may have a similar form, you know. Even appraisal company also having this, right? Actually, this is a real form. I have many forms from all the different kinds, even in Malaysia, Singapore, Thailand. So now the question is, you put a score here, like, you put, let's say, 5. But I'm not happy, I'm an employee, I say 5. Why might not mix? Oh, I think, look at this paper. I think you are not reaching basic expectation, always feel to carry out the task. Yesterday you asked me to do something I've done already. Why you say I'm not going to fail? It's not fair. So, over here, 1 to 10, even some, most of you are like 1 to 5, I know, right? So it's very, very difficult to justify the score of the rating. How can you justify? Anyone can give your feedback, right?
It must be something measurable.
It is measurable. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
No, I think it's that to be so that, for example, this employee, what type of task, whether they can manage to fulfill the deadline, or fulfill before the deadline, then you give them something like that.
Yep.
In terms of timeline, in terms of quality of the work.
Yes, correct. Certainly correct. Miss Ann, yeah. So she's getting there. So what she's trying to highlight to you, you cannot have just a general one for the entire form. The worst thing is you have the same form for everyone in the company. You have a paper and you give to the whole company, finance department, procurement department, warehouse department, all the department having the same form and same question, same evaluation. How is it relevant to the employee's performance? It's not. Let's say I'm the finance, planning and organizing. Maybe you say I'm doing accounting. What do you mean by planning and organizing? It's not relevant to me. I'm not doing planning. I just do my accounting, right? Setting objective, what is that? I don't understand, you know, I'm the employee. So depending on what level you are. So this is the issue, you know. And manager having difficulties to give the score, 1 to 10, how to give. Cannot give, I also cannot help you. So in summary, the problem is long list of checklist item. So you have a long list, right? What is the problem with a long list? Anyone? what is the problem with the long list? I can have 20 item measurement, wow, looks nice. 3 pages, wow, your appraisal form very comprehensive. Looks nice, right? What is the problem?
Malas.
Okay, long list is, malas is not a real problem, but the long list is you do not focus, you're not focused too many. Too many to measure. Let's say you have, I have 10 items, boss, which one I should focus on, right? So confusing, maybe not to find, cannot differentiate. Mixed up competency and KPI, this one is another issue. You look at the previous form, you have a competency inside there, you know, you also have KPI. All mixed up already, all mixed in one form, you just equalize it, all the weightages are equal. You have 1 to 10, 1 to 10, 1 to 10, just add up mathematically 120, you just divide by all, that's it. That is not accurate. That is just to fill in the form and submit, that's it. And big problem here, not aligned to the global goals. It is not aligned. If you're having the same form, you just fill in for the sake of HR chasing, you just fill in and submit, that's it, done. Right? So the first thing is, if HR, you have a HR system, you implement, your vendor tell you, okay, I have e-appraiser, electronic, it sounds good, right? Wow, I can do online, lah, efficiency, lah, can have report. Lah. It's a left pick up, isn't it? It does not solve the problem. Your e-appraiser cannot help you to solve this problem. Because your e-appraiser is designed, customized, exactly the same as your form. It's just do it online. The only benefit you have is you can have report instantly. You can submit HR, easy to chase, right? Only this benefit, but your CEO do not see that. No periodical review, this one is year end. Year end is too late. So that's why you know. That's why when you implement the appraisal, you invest a lot of money, and it doesn't work. Then you're wasting money for your company. One piece, depending on how here, I know now today, retaining talent is so important. So if you want to have a flexible working hour, right? Attendance, you have to ask yourself whether attendance is so important or not for that particular job. Or maybe a result that you want to drive. A lot of companies already started working from home. Unless you talk about the job, you require to be on time, like receptionist must be on time, the production workers, foreign workers have to be on time, attendance is important, right? So you cannot just use attendance across the board because certain people may not be able to do many. So we have to. Let's say the salary, this guy is 3,000. Okay? He's a top sales. You're very happy. You increase to 5,000. He's very happy, right? Next year, if his sales drop, not perform, can you reduce or not? A lot of bosses make the mistake. You very nice, I'm very good. Singapore, maybe more like not Malaysia.
Our company, yes, we do.
Oh, you do. Yeah, you must have a proper process. You see, the problem is, when you have a job profile, you need to define the job grade. What job grade means? You have a grade A, grade B, grade C, grade D. Maybe A is senior management. This one is management, maybe senior executive or executive. So we define that accountability, competency expected, skills, knowledge, and also responsibility. Because if the employee not willing to accept more responsibility, there is a salary range for this one. You set the salary range for each of these job profile. Do not simply increase. You can reward the employee by giving bonus, but not the increment. That's why a lot of bosses cannot reward. Maybe need to check with you how to do that. So when they increase the salary, they say, oh, stuck already. So now they all lazy already. You know? They have high salary, they're not going to perform. Right? So this one I just touch base to just share with you why a lot of SMEs having this issue. Increment and bonus. Okay? So now what we need to do is we need to focus on KPI. Because KPI is the one driving your company performance. Address your issue. Right? Affecting your profitability. Okay, KPI score is subjective.